Good afternoon, my name is David Loura and I'm presenting Interprofessional Competency Frameworks in Health to Inform Curricula Development Integrative Review. This work is related to the Train for Health, an educational research project which seeks to improve health students' competencies in supporting behavior change to effectively promote self-care in people with chronic diseases. The insurgence of a collaborative environment of practice and multi-professional healthcare teams enhance interprofessional education as it intends to break professional barriers and create cohesion in the healthcare team in a person-centered paradigm. Recognizing that generally students are still educated in silos, IPE intends to optimize students' resilience overcoming challenges when working with other healthcare professionals. Competency frameworks can serve as a guide to inform learning outcomes and curricular development and have been advocated in IPE as a form of improving interprofessional collaboration and patient care. Therefore, this review aims to identify interprofessional competency frameworks in health associated with the learning outcomes-based curricula. We conducted an integrative review applying the search strategy in 5 databases as described on the screen. Eligibility criteria included interprofessional frameworks with a link to learning outcomes. 4 articles were eligible, describing different interprofessional competency frameworks with participants from 12 diverse areas. The analyzed evidence suggests that IPE and collaboration shape the basis to develop competency-based education through ICFs. In the studies included, ICF's planning and development were carried out by a committee composed by several institutions as well as experts and stakeholders. Students were a constant component of these teams, participating in different activities undertaken to define ICFs, such as interviews, consensus meetings, and peer discussions. Documents defining professional competencies were often used as a starting point. Competency frameworks potentially provide an opportunity to foster learning outcomes-based curricula, assuming different learning outcomes regarding distinct levels of complexity and specialization. Amongst these, cognitive learning outcomes appear to be predominant. Despite the limitations presented, the evidence implies that competency framework can be useful guiding the development of learning outcomes-based curricula, supporting students, stakeholders, and experts' involvement in the process. Articulation between academic and clinical contexts, ideally resorting to structured scientific methods, may facilitate competency attainment and merits further attention. I leave you with our references. Feel free to contact us. You can follow the project on our social media. Thank you for your attention.